Hello and welcome back everybody to the Intricate Effects server. This is one Fred Jones. So today you guys, we're going to go on a little bit of an adventure. The guys on the server really want cactus and acacia wood. So we put up a vote in Skype and we talked about a couple different ways that we could go about getting that stuff. So one of the things we talked about was me jumping into creative mode and just giving myself one sapling and one cactus. Well, that didn't go. The guys don't want to do that. Another thing was expand out in one direction until we find a desert / savanna. The guys didn't want to do that either. They want to maintain the integrity of our border that we have set up here. And if you don't know, we're set up on a 2,000 by 2,000 area, which is only 1,000 blocks in each direction. Within those limitations, we do not have a desert or a savanna. So those are two items that the guys wish they had, and we don't have them. So the last thing we talked about was for me to go in. I'm the only one with the seed, so I took the seed, I put it into a program that allowed me to see the map, and I found the exact coordinates of the closest desert / savanna. And what we're going to do is I'm going to jump in the nether, I'm going to go to those coordinates in the nether. I'm going to make another portal. I'm going to jump through the nether portal. I'm going to get out. I'm going to grab some cactus. I'm going to grab an acacia sapling and jump back in the portal, destroy the portal, and then come home. So that's what we're going to do. It's going to, you know, help us maintain the integrity of our border. We're really waiting for 1.8 to come out. And even then, we might have some type of a border or limitations to the map size, because even after 1.8 comes out, we might, and I don't know, Minecraft's changing, Mojang's changing the way that they're building this game, so it may not be necessary to have a border, but it might. So we'll find out, we'll decide what we want to do when we get there. It's still a ways away, but before we go on our adventure, I want to show you what I've got done. I was also thinking about roads. Honestly, let's talk about that real quick. So, of course, we need a road going through here, right? So this is going to be the beginning of the road, and of course, it'll come this way and probably go down residential row. But we'll have a road come down through here, and I think it needs to drop down to like this level here, kind of cut around Town Hall, go right in front of the Enchanting Room, and then turn again here and go straight up to the Dye Farm. Then take a right and go over to the farm. Probably about right here. And then turn like so and go over to the animal farm. They come this way. And then we could lay out plots for people to build shops and things. So right up on that hill next to the farm can be a shop. We could probably put another shop in right here. So on and so forth. So let me know what you guys think about that idea for a road. If that sounds good to everyone, I think I may get started on that in the next few days before I take off. But let's go look at what I've got done so far over here on the farm. So this guy over here, it's completely functional. I put everything back to normal. All I really need to do now is an item elevator. This guy is one level. He may only stay one level, honestly, because this is working out pretty well. This one level right here. He doesn't have any mature ones in there, does he? No. But we'll have a door right here in the front. And then Marvin's been working on this right here, the redstone doctor. And that looks cool, but I think we need to move it over. He also put this like retaining wall in back here. He did most of this. Well, he did all of this actually back here. But I think we need to move it over a little bit. And then we'll have all the food items come up into a chest in this area right here from this farm, and then something similar on this side for that farm. So all I've really done so far is I got lucky. I got a farmer the first time I bred the villagers, so that worked out pretty good. Got him over here and set up the timer for our minecart. Oh geez, these doors. Well, it helps if you hit the stupid opening. There we go. All right, so there's a timer right down there. It's just, you know, the hopper clock that I always use. monostable circuit going into there, so on and so forth. This right here is going to have to be moved if we decide to do more than one level of farms, but I wanted to set it up and get it working. So far, not doing too bad. I don't know how long he's been working. Maybe an hour and a half, 2 hours in-game he's been working, and this is what he's come up with so far. But let's go ahead and do a little test here. I want to make sure his inventory is still full of seeds after all of his planting and harvesting he's been doing. So there he is. I'll go ahead and pick up this wheat he harvested. All right. Here, dude. Pick up some seeds. We had a whole stack on us, right? And we got a whole stack back. So, that's really cool. He will do that forever. He will sit there and he will harvest for us and replant and harvest and replant forever. All we have to do is run that minecart every so often via the clock, and we will get as much wheat as we could ever want. So cool, guys. All right, I'm going to go ahead and do some stuff. I'm going to clean up some stuff over here. I want to get this minecart track up before I forget about it or before I get too lazy to do it. And then we'll go get some saplings and some cactus. I'm ready to go now. I've got flint, steel, obsidian, food, torches, all the stuff I think we'll need. I'm not going to tell you guys too much about where this place is at, because I don't think the guys on the server would like it. But I will tell you that it is east. So we need to find east. Which way is east, I think? Yeah, that's facing west, so we need to go that way. Alright. And if I'm not mistaken, that's the direction for my fortress where the blaze spawner is. So, actually, I'm more than positive that's the right direction. So I'm probably going to go all the way over there. It's got to be past that fortress, so... And there's no way that it's, like, in the fortress or whatever. So, I'm going to get over there, and we're going to build a portal. So, I'll see you guys in a second. Okay, guys, we're here. Now I was right. The fortress is way back over there. So, let's go ahead and build this up. Oh. But first, let me throw that on the ground. So... I only brought 10 obsidian, that's all I had, so we can't make a full portal, but we can make one of these. And I don't know what time of day it is, and I didn't bring, like an idiot, I didn't bring an axe to cut down a tree. Alright. Download terrain, for crying out loud. Desert. Savannah. Perfect. Let's grab a cactus real quick. It's still daytime. Look at that ravine. Okay. I'll just grab a few of them. That way we can get some started when we get back. And this is something I ain't seen in a while. Except for on... Oh, look at that. That's cool. Look at that thing. Except for on Skyblock, where I was given cactus. Alright, let's get over here, cut down. We'll try to get 4 or 5 saplings. Okay. I feel stupid not bringing an axe. It looks like there's a roof forest over there as well. I don't know if this is a real popular wood. And I really honestly think that both the cactus and having the acacia wood, it's kind of one of those things where if you have it, you don't really think about it. And you may not even use it. But since you don't have it, you can't get it, you want it. That's kind of what I think is going on here. But there's been some things that I thought I could use some cyan dye for. I haven't been doing a whole lot of decorating, you know, or... You know, I don't do a whole lot of building anyways, but... is that all of them? I think that is all of it. So, It's not something I would use anyways, but the cyan dye is pretty cool. I do especially like it on the clay, the cyan dyed clay. Cyan. So, I definitely don't blame the guys for wanting this stuff. So we'll chop down two trees. Look at this acacia tree over here. That thing is cool looking. To my right. Let's get a better look at it. Oh, that thing is awesome. That's like the perfect acacia tree. Wow. Okay, well, it's getting dark. Last thing I want to do is get caught out here in the dark. I did bring some torches and stuff, so... might have started punching these leaves. Did I leave a log up in there somewhere? No, it's despawning. I did cut down a tree earlier today. I did get, oh, there's one sapling there. Just wait for all these leaves to despawn. Actually, we can help her along here, I suppose. Get up there. But I thought I'd do this on camera, so, you know, if you're watching someone else's video, and you're like, hey, you're not supposed to have cactus, or cyan dye, or whatever, you'll know how we got it. One sapling's all we're going to get out of that tree. That is wonderful. Let's go see what's going on with this other one. Did I not get all the logs out of this one? Looks like I did. Give me more saplings! Alright guys, I'll tell you what, I'm just gonna... oh, there's another sapling there. Two saplings, that's probably enough. I'll go ahead and... yeah, there's another one, okay. We're good, that's all the saplings we probably need. Where'd it go? There it is. We'll get rid of our evidence here, and we'll jump back in the portal, and go back home. And we'll set up a little... oh yeah, here comes the bad guys. We'll set up a little deal at spawn so everybody can see that there's cactus and stuff. I'll tear down this portal when we get back through. Okay. And then I'm also going to fill in this hole I dug too. I don't want any evidence of where I went or anything. So, I'll see you guys when we get back to spawn. Alright guys, we're back over here at the hub. We'll go grab some sand from my house, because we should, yep, come out right behind my house. We need to get the portals figured out, because that's not where we want the spawn portal to be. But we'll go grab some sand, and then we'll set up a little cactus farm, grab some bones. If I knew which chest my sand was in. Oh, I also got a gas tier. Forgot about it. Okay, and then some bones, there's some bone meal actually, we'll just grab a stack of bone meal. Get away from these loud villagers. Oh, I'm really thinking about just moving those guys somewhere out of my life. But yeah, I know P-Town's going to need some, so we'll probably build it right in front of his dye shop. So yeah, I think that that's a good idea for the road, and then you come through here with the road, then have it turn right, and then I think right here is where we should put the Intricate Effect logo, the one that Monkey Boy came up with, and then do a road around this way as well, going around the logo, and then we can put more shops around here, stuff like that. So that's my idea. Let's see here, let's do... ooh, not quite like that. We have 7, so that's all I'm going to worry about right now is 7 spots. Just do it. Dang it. Actually, I might. Actually, I think I will. I'm going to stay here while the cactus grows. And we're going to prank old P-Town a little bit. And I'm going to put cactus all around the front of his dye farm. Oh, one more. Let's skip one spot there. Put some sand in. What did I do that for? Do that, Fred, doofus. Okay, like that, we'll let that grow, and then let's come over here and do an acacia tree right there. Boom. That's a nice one too, huh? Man, those are cool trees. I wish they were, different colors. Let's do one right here. Ended up with four saplings. I only thought I had three. Ended up with four. That's a tall one. Jeez Louise. And like that. And you know what? I might leave those just like that here at spawn for right now. And the guys, if they got any decency at all, they'll cut one down and then replant it, letting everyone get a chance for an acacia tree. But that's going to be all for today. I want to thank you guys for watching. And remember, I love you, all five of you.